beach and the great outdoors over summer now poses a serious health risk. To combat this, hundreds of new sunscreens now fill the shelves of supermarkets and pharmacies. They offer protection from the sun and a catalogue of benefits. Helen Wellings enlisted the help of skin cancer experts to pinpoint the very best.
The best investment in your skincare to prevent against ageing is a good sunscreen.
We should always wear sunscreen outdoors to guard against the harsh Australian sun. But certain ones with the latest prevention technology and fantastic ingredients work far better than others, and some won't work at all. So how do you choose the best one for you from the hundreds of different types on the market?
There are three things people should look for when they're shopping for a sunscreen. One is that it's an SPF 30+, which is the highest rating. It should be water resistant, and it should say that it's broad spectrum, which means that it deals with both types of ultraviolet radiation.
And how and exactly where to put it on is critical. But most of us haven't a clue how much slip, slap and slopping is enough to protect us.
Almost 400,000 people a year in Australia are diagnosed with some form of skin cancer, and over 1,500 a year are dying from skin cancer.
It's all that little bit of sun you're getting every single day, that cumulative damage, which in the end is going to give you problems not only with cancer, but pigmentation, broken capillaries and that sallow sort of chicken skin appearance, which is very hard to rectify once it comes. So you need to prevent it. Great for the body, fantastic outdoor sporting sunscreens.
We asked dermatologist Dr. Natasha Cook to recommend her best sunscreens for the face and body, for everyday protection, also for the beach and sport, and her surprising advice on just how to apply it for top results. First, what a sunscreen needs to make it work.
You really should be aiming to buy an SPF 30+. And under Australian standards, a 30+, which statistically could be anything from 30 to 120. So you're actually getting a lot of protection in that.
Then look for active ingredients, zinc and or titanium. They're physical blockers that reflect the sun from our skin, essential for sunscreen to work. These days, zinc, nanonized zinc or zinc oxide, is invisible.
All the labels on sunscreens will tell you what the ingredients are.
The Cancer Council's Anita Teng says make sure you get UVA and UVB protection. Ultraviolet A penetrates the top layer of skin, which can lead to malignant skin cancer, melanomas, as well as sunburn, sagginess, blotchiness and reduction of collagen. Ultraviolet B causes sunburn, ageing skin, wrinkles and yellow or brown spots.
So Natasha, when you're going to the beach, what's best to wear?
Dr. Natasha Cook's four top body sunscreens all contain zinc or titanium or both, are 30+, broad spectrum and water resistant. Ego Sunscent Sport Milk, UV Triple Guard Everyday Lotion, Priceline Sunsport and the Cancer Council's Classic Sunscreen.
This one in particular has got the nanonized zinc, but it's also a little bit lighter than the others, I find.
Now, for the face.
For your face, Natasha's top three sunscreens that won't block pores. Shiseido Gentle Sun Protection Lotion, Invisible Zinc New Generation Sun Care by Gainhill, and Hamilton Everyday Face Light Moisturising Cream. And what most people don't know, use lots.
Now, if you don't put enough on of your sunscreen, your protection will actually go from a 30 plus down to something like a 6.
You need actually about a teaspoon per limb, and we know that actually a lot of people aren't using anywhere near that. The other thing is that to make it work the best, you should put it on before you go outdoors to let it bind into your skin before it needs to work, and you should reapply every couple of hours.
So what's really important is after you've cleansed and moisturised is to make sure you get a nice, thick, even consistency with your sunscreen. When you apply it, you're actually going to get proper protection. It's important to rub it in or even just to put it on and then wait for about 10 or 15 minutes and let it soak in.
Dr. Cook says this morning routine of moisturiser and sunscreen on the face, not forgetting the neck and chest, takes time.
I'd say probably about 20 to 30 minutes because you really should give yourself a good 10 to 15 to let it absorb, re-massage it in, and then afterwards put your makeup on over the top that should have an SPF in it. On top of your sunscreen, it's always great to invest in a makeup or a powdered makeup that's actually got SPF in it just to finish off your protection, which will also enhance your look, minimise the sheen that sometimes can occur with some sunscreens and give you a nice even look as well as providing you with additional protection.
And of course, all of those details are on our website.